Welcome to Why Wait NKM. I am your girl and your host, Capital A. And you could have been doing anything else with your time, but you chose to rock with me. And I greatly appreciate it. Today, we have special guests, Dallas own Cornelius Beats. Today, we're going to talk about his awesome career and the fact that he's the CEO of All Star Magazine, as well as how to become the artist that everyone is talking about. So, and we also have music by my favorite DJ, DJ Genius. I'm going to give you a couple of tips about how to become the artist that everyone's talking about. Network with other artists. Networking with other artists is key to finding great ways to get your music reviewed and featured. Why? Because other artists have done much of the footwork that you have not done, or vice versa. Network with those artists that are like you and see if you can share connections between your entities. A great collaboration will open many doors for all involved. Embrace local. You should never underestimate your local media, including the local paper, magazines and blogs, forums, and other local resources. Take some time to get to know the editors for these outlets and find if they still exist where you live. The music stores around you, and get to know the folks in charge of featuring music in store. Your hard work could lead to one of many local outlets featuring you because you are a part of the local artistic economy. I don't know why I can't talk today. And because you've taken the time to show why you're worth featuring. Later in the show, we'll discuss more about how to become the artist everyone's talking about. And now for That's Dope. The wait is over. Guess who is officially inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame class of 2017? Tupac. Yes, other acts who will also be receiving the honor are Pearl Jam, Journey, Electric Light Orchestra, and more. To be eligible, nominees had to release their first album or single at least 25 years ago. The induction ceremony will be held at Brooklyn's Barclays Center, April 7, 2017, while an edited version will later air on HBO. There will be a radio broadcast on Sirius XM. In recent years, the Hall of Fame's foundation has increasingly found rap artists to be worthy of induction. Five other hip-hop acts have been inducted: N.W.A. in 2016, Public Enemy in 2013, The Beastie Boys in 2012, Run D.M.C. 2009, and Grand Master Flash and the Furious Five in 2007. Tupac Shakur will make history as the first solo hip-hop artist to be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Now that's dope. I have a special announcement. Brooklyn's own rapper Troy Ave is giving you an opportunity to collaborate. For features, hosting, and a show booking, contact Dope, D-O-P-E, Boy, B-O-Y-K-I-N-G-T-R-P-Y at gmail.com. And now for What's in Your Stocking segment. This month we have a new segment called What's in Your Stocking, and I'm sharing with you some of the hottest singles, mixtapes, and albums that just dropped, just in time for you to place them in your music lover's stocking this year. So the hot new releases, these are the singles. Troy Ave, Loco, can be found on SoundCloud. Tony Terry's December Goodbye, featuring Silver Logan Sharp, is on iTunes. Kenny Lattimore. These are the albums now. Kenny Lattimore, A Kenny Lattimore Christmas. My favorite single was Real Love This Christmas. Anthony Hamilton, Home for the Holidays. My favorite on this album is Tis the Season. Solange Knowles, A Seat at the Table. My favorite song for this album so far is Cranes in the Sky, Mad, and Rise so far. Joe, My Name is Joe. My favorite song for this album is No Chance and Lean Into It. And now for performance opportunities. Promoters Worldwide, if you have any performance opportunities for any independent artists, no matter where you are, please send your details to wwenradio@gmail.com, and I'll make sure I share the information on air. And now, for my favorite segment, DJ Genius, it's your time to shine. Drop that beat for me one time. DJ Genius.
DJ Genius. Genius.
back, welcome back, welcome back. You've tuned in to Why Wait, Educate Now. And if you just tuned in, I greatly appreciate it. If you've been rocking with us, thank you so much. I want to introduce you to my special guest, CEO, music director, music video director, producer, and so much more, Cornelius Beats. Welcome to the show.
What's going on now? You all right?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. Just trying to get rich like y'all up there.
I got you. So, I didn't know that you've been in the industry for over 10 years. And I know I know that you started as an artist at the age of 12. Who inspired you to become an artist?
I used to always see my auntie Erica do music and stuff like that. She actually, you know, showed me how to play the piano. So, from there, I was just like, well, she sings. I'm pretty sure I can do it, too. So, I kind of got in the industry kind of through her, you know?
Okay, I got you. So, all right, 3 years later, you started your own label at the age of 15. Why transition from artist to owning your own label so quickly?
Well, the reason why I did that is because, like, growing up, I've always been, you know, an entrepreneur. I've always wanted to do my own thing and start my own business. So, I was like, well, okay, well, If I could be an artist, then I'm sure I can own my own label. Like, okay. it must not be that hard, you
know?
So I had a group of friends and stuff like that that rapped and wanted to. It was kind of my studio, so I was just like, well, you know what? If I can make money off these guys, like, why not come up with my own little gang or team or something like that to make stuff happen with them? So I kind of started a label. It was called Black Heart Entertainment. It was a whole lot of doing stuff, you know, as a young child comes up.
Right, I got you. So, let me ask you, who was your support system and mentors during that transition?
During that transition, my mom was a big mentor to me. She was pretty much the only one that really supported me and stuff like that. RIP to my mom, by the way.
Aww.
she was my number one fan and my support system for, you know, becoming the person and stuff like who I am. So that's kind of how that started. My auntie as well. I don't want to leave her out. But my mom was a really, really big support system.
Oh, that's what's up, though. Okay. So let's see. Let's talk about the magazine. You've had five years later, you became the CEO of yet another lucrative business with All Star Magazine. How did you go from 1 to 20 million subscribers?
Well, okay. It's kind of interesting. I was working a day job. I was a security guard for the security company. Mm-hmm. And actually, I'm going to kind of start from the front of how I got started or whatever. But I was actually working, sitting on my desk, and I was like, you know what, I'm tired of clocking in these hours. I'm just sick of it, you know? I just want to do my own thing. I know I could do it. Like I said, I always been a little entrepreneur growing up, but I'm older now, so I know I have a lot more leverage. So, you know, being a music producer and working with some of the people that I, you know, have connections to in the industry, I was just like, okay, well, I already built my name in the industry and stuff like that. If I can't get through this way as an artist, I'm sure I can as a businessman.
I got you.
You know?
Yeah.
So I started All Star Magazine, and what I did was I actually when I first started, I didn't have anybody to know about All Star Magazine, but I used a lot of my connections to really kind of, you know, not necessarily co-sign, but help me out.
I got you.
And to help me get the name out there and spread awareness and stuff like that, you know? So that's kind of how I did that. Like just already having a name as a music producer and an artist, a lot of people respected me and they just kind of jumped on it.
Okay, I got you.
Yeah.
So you cover music industry trends, interviews, and major artists like Big Sean, as well as independent artists like Dallas, Texas own MO3.
Right.
How is your magazine different from XXL, Source, or Hip Hop Weekly?
Okay, so All Star Magazine is different because XXL, Hip Hop Weekly, all of those magazines are news based.
Okay.
We're based on visuals.
Okay.
So everything that we produce, like even if you go to our website, it's based on a video or some type of visual that you can actually see or read. You know?
I got you.
That's the difference between our publication and their publication.
Okay. That's what's up. As far as you directing, now I've seen a whole bunch of videos, but I know that you've directed many music videos and performances. Who would you say was the most memorable?
Everybody would want me to say Mo3. But I think actually I did a TV show for Master P called The Next Top CEO.
Okay.
And I think that was the one that was the most, you know, the kind of thing that I really enjoyed doing because it was something different.
Yeah.
It was something different. It was actually about non-working single fathers that had felonies and couldn't get a job. So
I actually
really enjoyed that because he was actually helping
right.
people, you know, be successful and helping them get their life on track and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
I like
that. Was the one that I really liked.
Okay. That's what's up. I like that too. Like the idea of it, and hopefully it's something that more people will know about now that, you know, you said it on the show, because I didn't know about it, but you just enlightened me to some great information. So for my listeners, that thank you for saying and sharing that with us.
No problem. Well, actually, the show haven't came out yet. That's why you haven't heard about it.
It
haven't started. It haven't even been marketed or nothing like that.
Oh, you gave me an exclusive then.
Yeah, you got an exclusive.
Okay. I feel special.
The show that you're hearing about right now is Growing Up Hip Hop.
Okay.
Stuff like that. So we actually got a new show coming out. It's called The Next Top CEO, and it's taking, you know, non-working single fathers and stuff like that. That's on child support and, you know, a whole lot of stuff. So
yeah, I like
just
that.
Just helping people.
Okay, well, I got to chop it up with you about that after the show.
Okay.
All right. Now, as far as you being a producer, how long have you been a producer?
I've been producing music since the age of 12.
Okay, so you started back then. All right.
Yeah, I didn't want to pay for music and stuff like that. I just got tired of people, you know, prolonging on my beats and wanting them to make a beat, and I had to pay for it. So I was just like, you know, well, if they can do it, I can do it too.
Right.
Yeah, I just started at the age. You know, it's crazy. I still have the first beat I ever made.
Really?
I got to send it to you, too.
Yeah, I need to hear that.
Yeah, so
okay.
That's kind of how I started making beats and stuff. And then, you know, just being in the music industry, just meeting new people.
Right.
It just kept me going at it.
Okay. Now, did you have, you know, coming up along the way, I mean, you were 12 starting out, so of course you perfected your skills and your craft over time. Who would you say was most influential to you as far as, you know, learning to be a producer? Who were your mentors?
See, at the age of 12, I really didn't know about a lot of producers and stuff like that. I've always watched Ryan Leslie.
Okay.
Are you familiar with him? He's like a producer, singer, and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I've always watched him. He was a really big inspiration on why I even started producing.
Okay.
So I watched him because he was really different. He was really articulate.
Right.
Stuff like that. So that's kind of what kept me motivated and, you know, making my music and stuff like that.
Okay. So who have you worked with as far as producing?
I've worked with Diamond from Crime Mob.
Okay.
I worked with Master P.
Nice.
I got some stuff going with 50 Cent right now.
Okay.
For music for Power.
Mm-hmm.
I
love that show.
Yeah, no. you'll be hearing some of my music on there. So
okay, that's what's up.
I work with a lot of independent, but majority of heavy hitters.
I got you.
Stuff like that. So I'll be going on and on and on.
Yeah. Well, now what you shared was plenty, and I thank you for sharing that. You have, well, I guess you just told me some of them. Any current projects that we should be out on the lookout for?
Yeah, actually, I'm working with an artist by the name of Jay Fresh.
Okay.
He just dropped a project called Gemini, the mixtape. And then I produced his whole mixtape and stuff like that and produced all his videos. He's actually signed on my label off of Music Group. So That's something that I got coming up. And then we have the Industry Connect with All Star Magazine.
Right.
In Bangladesh. Yeah, in Bangladesh. If you don't know who Bangladesh is, he produced Get It On Him for Nicki Minaj, I'm looking for Lil Wayne, and a whole lot of other hits for Lil Chris.
Okay.
But that's kind of what I got coming up right now.
Okay. Well, I'm going to ask you a little bit more about that later in the show. But I want to say this. Grind should be your middle name. But I salute
it
you.
Is.
Yeah, you be on
it's
it,
my,
I swear.
It's my first name.
It's your first name? Okay, let me switch his first name from Cornelius to Grind. And I salute you for all your accomplishments and the love that you show for independent artists in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Much respect to you.
Right. No problem. And thank you. Thank you so much.
All right, so we're going to go into commercial. When we come back, we're going to talk more about how to become the artist everyone's talking about, as well as we're going to find out who the hottest artists in Texas are right now. All right, stay tuned.
Out.
Welcome back. Early in the show, we gave tips of how to become the artist everyone's talking about. And we also have special guest CEO Cornelius Beats on the air. Hello, sir. How are you?
I'm pretty good. How about yourself?
I'm good. So, Cornelius, when it comes to running your own magazine, what would you say an independent artist would need to accomplish to catch your attention and receive an interview?
Well, you know, in this music industry, there's so many people trying to be the next person. It's not really necessarily catching my attention. I'd rather for artists to catch the people's attention first.
I got you.
The people is going to catch my attention, you know?
Right.
But that's kind of what I would, you know, kind of some advice to give to independent artists.
Okay.
You got to catch the consumer's attention first. Like, if you don't catch the consumer's attention, I mean, I'm not even going to know about you, you know?
Right. Exactly.
Okay. Yeah, that's how it goes in this industry.
Right. And I mean, that's worldwide. I mean, it's not just... Or industry-wide, it's not just for a magazine. That's for managers or producers or anybody. You know, they want to know that they're working with somebody that's dope, and it's based off of word of mouth. So if nobody's talking about you, then it's kind of hard for, you know, somebody else to put you in a platform to spread and not just be local, but be worldwide. So I totally get that.
Exactly.
So who would you say is the hottest artist in Texas right now, and why?
Well... The hottest artist in Dallas, Texas is Mo3.
Okay.
The reason why he's the hottest artist in Dallas, Texas, is because he have a team of people that's working on his behalf that's keeping him hot, like myself and, you know, other parts of the team that works with Mo3.
Right.
He's really talented, and he knows how to stay relevant.
I got you.
That's why he's the hottest artist in Dallas. He just has the music and the appeal that everybody wants and everybody that's missing.
I got you. Okay. That's what's up. So, you have the Music Industry Connect event coming up January 14th, which is powered by All Star Magazine. Why is this event for independent artists? Why is this event so, important? And why does this event need to be one that independents do not need to miss?
The reason why this event is so important is because it's a lot of stuff that happens in, you know, the music cultures and not only just independent artists, but like everybody that's trying to be a star in the music industry.
Right.
They're really misled, and a lot of people is going to be at this event that can actually change your life and help you in your career. And we're actually going to be informing and teaching people the music industry and how to maneuver through certain situations in their career.
Okay.
So that's why it's really important for artists to be, you know, to be attendance in this event and stuff like that.
Right.
And then also when you attend the event, you get a free ad with All Star Magazine.
Okay.
That's what's
up. Right. That's what's up. Now, I went to the one, 2015. That's where I met you, was at your Industry Connect event.
Right.
And so it was very informative. I want to tell all the listeners, you know, this is one you do not want to miss. You know, a lot of people say, okay, well, I have panels and I have this, that, and the third, and it's not helpful, but every person that you had as your guest gave some valuable information and tips and tools of how to be successful in the industry, signed or not. And I love that. So salute to you for doing that and having it in the area where, you know, a lot of people would say, okay, well, there's not a lot of help, or, you know, people don't in the industry don't really pay attention to the Dallas-Fort Worth area. That's not true, but you're doing something to change that. And I appreciate that.
Exactly. And that's why it's important for artists to come, is because it's actually a real opportunity. You know, artists have been misled so much.
Right.
Where they don't even believe the new opportunities or some of the real opportunities in front of their face. So
right.
It's really important because... And then I even reached out to, you know, Bangladesh to even let people know he got over 5 Grammys.
Right.
And over 15 years in this game. And, you know, I reached out to him to actually, you know, shine light and a lot of people information that can be used to their advantage, you know?
That's what's up. And I salute to him for taking time out of his day to even come, you know what I'm saying, and speak on it. You know, he don't, these people don't have to, you know what I'm saying? Like, they've done what they need to do to be successful. They don't have to come back and give you that wisdom. So please, independent artists that are planning to attend, take heed to everything that, you know, these industry professionals have to say, because they're taking the time out to make sure that you're squared away and you have things correct. So.
Right.
All right. So I want to ask you a question. I'm be nosy. Who's on your top 10 in your playlist right now?
There's a lot of independent artists.
Okay, share.
So, but crazy thing is, I don't even know their names.
What?
A lot of people give me music, and I don't really know their names. One of them is my artist, Big Fresh.
Okay.
Okay, Mo 3. I like Go Yeah, he's out in Dallas.
Okay.
Them kind of the only people that I really listen to like that.
Okay. I mean, but that's your playlist. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to be mad because, you know, that's, I'm not going to tell you who to put in your playlist. You know what I mean? That's who you digging right now.
I listen to a lot of indie music.
But that's what's up, though.
Right.
Independent artist, you listening? He listens to indie artists. I'm just saying. Might want to shout out to him. That's all I'm saying.
I listen to a lot of indie music. Okay. That's the most creative music out right now.
I got you. I feel you on that. Any advice you want to give to the up and coming entrepreneurs who desire to have their own magazine?
Well, I got information to people that want to start their own business. Okay. If you want to be successful in life, you have to stay consistent. Anything that's worth having comes with a struggle.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
So you gotta stay consistent. You gotta be motivated, self-motivated. Mm-hmm. You have to read. You have to read, and you have to sit down and read for days and hours. You know, stuff like that. I mean, you know, everything is in a book, and
right.
knowledge is power. So you gotta be willing to do things that you're the unusual.
Right.
That
I
know?
Got you. Okay.
But yeah, if you want to be successful in business, and I don't care if it's starting your own magazine, being a dope artist, or, you know, reaching your goal, trying to get a deal, you gotta stay consistent.
Right, that's key.
Yeah,
that's great advice.
And no business too.
Right. Okay, so if someone wanted to follow you, which they should, how can they get in contact with you? Social media, websites? Give us the tea.
Well, if you want to contact me on anything. For one, if you don't want to, you know, just go social media, you can actually Google my name. It's Cornelius Beats. It's CornelliusButz.
Okay.
I mean, excuse me, it's B. I can't even get it out. My man over here laughing at me right now. Yeah, it's CorneliusBeats@gmail.com if you want to contact me directly. And Cornelius Beats on all my social media. So,
okay, yeah. That's what's up.
That's what it is.
I got you already.
And then you can also follow All Star Magazine. Look up All Star Magazine, and it's on every social platform there is.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Cornelius, for being my special guest. For all your insight as well as your advice. And I want to say happy holidays to you and yours.
Thank you as well.
Thank you. All right. So I also want to say thank you to DJ Genius. I greatly appreciate you for keeping the listeners entertained. If you want to hear more of DJ Genius, check out his website at djgenius.com. There you can tune into his show, DJ Genius Mix Show, on Genius Music Radio Mondays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Eastern, and Fridays from 4 p.m. to 6:30 p.m. Eastern. You can follow this show, Why We Educate Now, on Facebook at WWN Radio. And for Instagram and Twitter, it's WWEN Radio 924. And if you want to view previous episodes of Why We Educate Now, you can go to WWEN Radio at... No, WWE... I can't even get my own thing right. WWEN Radio 924.com. Okay, got it out. Thank you to all my listeners across the globe. Much love and respect to you. Shout out to my son, Xavier Scott. Happy holidays to you. My better half, Estevan Garvin. Family and friends who support me unconditionally. I love you guys to the moon and back. And when we come back, we're going to go into the Indie Artist Spotlight.
DJ Genius.
Spotlight. These are the features.
Chevelle on them blades, boy. Dark shades, leather jacket like I'm Blade, boy. Chopping through my city like, what's the focus, boy? I come through with open doors. 6x9s through these door panels make a bunch of noise. I'm mobbing on these back streets and city blocks. Middle finger to every cop. Chevy block engines, everything is heavy stock. I'm in my sweatpants, the car dancing. I make that bitch do the wop, man. I'm losing my religion. Got these angels on my shoulders and they telling me to listen. I just blast this Alpine and get lost in my system. They telling me it's devil music and demons have imprisoned my mind, body, and soul. And I'm traveling down hell's road and I just left Skid Row. The strap got no Velcro, so I'm down for whatever, whenever, wherever. Any way the hell I go, you think I'm scared? Here's your answer. Hell no.
Yo, too high, what up?
Let's play freeze tag with ice picks. Night shift selling white shit to white chicks. Let's play freeze tag with ice picks. Night shift selling white shit to white chicks. Let's play freeze tag with ice picks. Night shift selling white shit to white chicks. Let's play freeze tag with ice picks. Night shift selling white shit to white chicks. Bikes with vice grips, scuffed up huffies. For the crime, do shine time, that's fucked up. The type to get fucked up monthly, beat down daily, and smoke up your disability check. Sean Price bout as real as it get. I'm no fool, I'm old school, like I'm artist Gilmore with the sketch. If you walk on my block and talk about rough, you get touched, motherfucker, cause you talk too much. Come walk with P, so you all can see how I get those spit flows to an awkward beat. Better look both ways before you cross the street. The Pirellis on the Porsche push you off your feet. One half of the incredible rap team. Y'all niggas smoked out. Incredible crap.
Hey, y'all niggas is too old to think the way you do. And you cowards never do what you say you do. I'm in the hood running with the same crazy crew. And you ain't nice, you sound like Jay-Z too. Niggas is frontin', word up, acting like bad boys. Y'all move in silence, we make mad noise. When it's beef in the streets, we don't try and make peace. I got killers that just blaze and they'll make peace. S dots, eyes are with the long sleeve. Ghetto bitch, fat ass with the long
weave. Hey, yo, get down, lay down, everybody get on the floor. This is beef, you don't want that bar. Better warn everybody,
three-star camouflage, Marv the ball, vodka, cognac, it's a Mardi Gras. Pull a three-star camouflage, Marv the ball, vodka, cognac, it's a Mardi Gras. Pull a three-star camouflage, Marv the ball, vodka, cognac, it's a Mardi Gras. Pull a three-star camouflage, Marv the ball, vodka, cognac, it's a Mardi Gras. Roll a big Marley, y'all, burn those cigars. I got mommy in the back with the guard. Back to the car, hit it in the back of the car. Had me fiddling with the latch on the bra. I was tugging at the strap on a thong. Thugging like a rap nigga song. Grinding till the crack of the dawn. She make a nigga wanna come back in the morn. Make her want a nigga back after I'm gone. That's what I'm on. Baby got back, word is born. Have you like damn, that shit is wrong. Have you like damn, that shit is all. Strip down, lay down, sell off dogs, do it raw. Four door, gator four, on 24s. Bucktail, USA, connect with your boys.
Yo, shorty look good. Nah, she ugly, but I'm drunk as hell, so fucking shorty look good. The bitch did eat, plus she smoked good trees. So me being who I be, I had to do me. The bitch wanted me to straight spend the cash. Slow dub, slow fuck, titty pin the grass. No, I'm quick to bend your ass the fuck over now. Jump in your Tim's and dash, yo. She talking about that ain't fair. Bitch, that's $2, fuck you mean that ain't fair. Yo, Sean Price and the price is cheaper. Only splurge on iceberg, Nikes and reefer. Timberland boots and plus a gun to shoot. And a pocket full of coke in case I don't recoup. Cause time is money and money is time. And I got just enough time to get that money.
Hey yo, get down, lay down. Everybody get on the floor. This is beef, you don't want that bar. Better warn everybody in your city or town. Let them know what, this is the shakedown. Hey yo, get down, lay down. Everybody get on the floor. This is beef, you don't want that bar. Better warn everybody in your city or town. Let them know what, this is the shakedown.
Shakedown.
One ride, they all ride, all around the world with the family. No tall guy, alkaline base for the
family. No fluoride, it ain't gonna take you to dare me for y'all to all die. Yeah, they still loving the performance. Stashing accounts, all of them is enormous. Had to stay on point, cause they wasn't gonna want us. Only three man group where all of them is the strongest. Ha, we got big shit to talk about. If you see the wine in the glass, you know the cork is out. See the mink down in my ass, you know the hawk is out. Soon as you hear the three letters, you know New York is out.
I ride with you. Cruise up and ride with you. Smoke a little loud with you. If it's alright with you. Cause we got big shit to talk about.
It's nothing to talk about.
Like how we gon' make it out.
It's nothing to
I think I got it all figured out.
It's nothing to
cause it's
I swear I'm not frowning on you. Look, when you getting money, it's really nothing to do. But I swear I'm not frontin' on you. Nah. Look, I need something to do. Just don't make me do something to you. You know the godson go black, black, black. You know the godson go black, black, black. You know the godson.
Pull out fake, killin' him, fake, killin' him.
Murder he wrote, I ain't feeling him. Burner in the cold, that's a still with him. Well, it's cold outside, try to chill with him. I don't like nothing them punks say. Virgin wording, they fucking up the feng shui. Killer rhymer with just a liner. Flow smooth, so pajamas in the Bahamas. Aiding designer, that's how I taught it. Get money off the books, you can't get audit. Me and my father shopping, it's fresh, you know we bought it. Even my pop fly, I hope you caught it. Tell your wife I'ma hit her, please. I'm fucking with my dogs, I ice pick a knee. Dogs, notice I said pick a knee. Who's as nice to me spitting beats? Come on. It's nothing to do, but I swear I'm not frying on you. Look, when you getting money, it's really nothing to do. But I swear I'm not frying on you, nah. Look, I need something to do. Just don't make me do something to you. You know the godson go black, black, black. You know the godson go black, black, black.
Hey, you tuned in to Why Wait Educate Now. Next week's host is going to be Dallas, Texas zone from K104, Kiki J. We're going to talk about her career, her accomplishments, and Street Swag Sunday. We're also going to talk about what to do as far as radio spins, what to do before and after for airplay. So we'll see you soon. I hope everybody has a great holiday. Happy holidays from us, from our family, to yours. See you soon.
Capo, I got these niggas. Harlem, you know how that go. Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get even.
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get even.
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get even.
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get even.
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get even.
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get even.
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get even.
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get even.
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get even.
Eastside.
Revenge is only natural, time to get even. We pick and roll when the cold, time to switch seasons. Trip to Belize, 100 keys to leave your kids bleeding. Ball main sweatsuit, trying to hide at the grip peeking. Came from a hole in the wall, cracking the concrete. I want Giuseppe's, not no LeBron sneaks. My palms read, cash in my future days. Think about my past life. Model bitch and blow me like a bag. Nine, they said I was a criminal. I just can't get caught yet. Think I got a warrant now, cause I ain't caught in the court. 30 bricks that had you paranoid, just like Ross said. 30 bricks that had you paranoid, just like Ross said. 30 bricks that had you paranoid, just like Ross said. 30 bricks that had you paranoid, just like Ross said. 30 bricks that had you paranoid, just like Ross said. Used to do the Gore-Tex, come to Harlem, we all fresh. Capo told me these niggas is in denial. Forgot what river we left his body, think it's the now. Time for a flight jacket, prices ain't coming down. Couldn't smoke on them trips, turn pipe with a couple pills. Chill, chill, you making it hot. My whole block got indicted, they just raided the spot. I woke up in the kitchen, I was scraping the pot. I got it from my plug and took it straight to the block.
Chill, I heard they confiscated the trap. They said the feds was on his ass when he was making the trap. They gave the nigga 10, I hope he make it up top. They said the nigga turned Muslim, now we making Salat. Champ. Supreme Bean and Supreme J. Cross 10th in the bed where the fiends play. Uptown, Rucker Park, I seen Kareem play. I'm talking bigs.